Okay, in this video, we will see the construction of a 4x4 RAM, or you can say that this is a design of the 4x4 RAM. Suppose if you are asked about to design a 4x4 RAM, then this will be the solution. Or if you are asked to explain the construction of a 4x4 RAM, then also this will be the solution. So in this video, we will see the construction of a 4x4 RAM. So here we have this 4x4 RAM. Okay, so here we have seen that we have some binary cells, binary cell, each of these are binary cells. So these are the inputs I3, I2, I1 and I0. So these are the four parallel input bits, and similarly here we have four outputs. So this is called a 4x4 RAM because here you can see here we have four columns of binary cells and four rows of binary cells. That is why this is called as a 4x4 RAM. So before understanding this 4x4 RAM, we have to go to our previous video. The operation of a or the function of a binary cell we have seen here. So we have already seen that whenever we have the select line is equal to 0, this circuit will not have any impact on the output. Okay, that means this circuit you can assume it to be disconnected. Next, whenever we have the select line is equal to 1, then this circuit will do the read or write operation. So we have already seen that whenever we have read or write signal is equal to, if we have here 0, this write is the active low signal. So we can say that this circuit will do the write operation. So whenever we have 1, this read or write bar signal is equal to 1, then we will have the read operation. Okay, this read operations means whatever be the content of this Q value or this content of this SR flip-flop output, we will read. That means this output, SR flip-flop output, will be available here at this output point. And whenever we have the write operation, this 0 applied here, this output will be disconnected, and whatever we have at this input, this will be written into this flip-flop. So we have already seen this operation. I will give the link of this video in the description section of this video. Okay, for this circuit, here we can see that we have three inputs. One is the select input, one is input bits, and here we have the read write. Okay, and we have single output. So this is the block diagram of this binary cell. So here we can see that we have a select line input, we have one input data, and we have a read or write bar signal, and this is the only single output. That means we have three inputs and one output. So for understanding the operation of this binary cell, please follow the link in the description section for this binary cell operation. So in this 4x4 RAM, we have four binary cells in the columns and four rows of binary cells. That means here we have to use 16 binary cells. So these are the binary cells. Here you can see that for each cell, there are three inputs. This is select input, this is input line, because this is connected here, you can see. And this one is the third input, is the read or write operation we have applied here. Okay, this line is coming here, and we have applied here the read or write bar. Okay, that means depending on the signal, data will be written into this memory cell, or the content of these binary cells will be read, and this content will be available at this output. Here we can see that we have four OR gates. This OR gate operation is that if any one of the OR gate input is 1, that will be available at the output. So at the left hand side of this 4x4 RAM, here we have used here a 2x4 decoder. So we have already seen our previous lectures about the decoder circuit. Okay, I will give you the link of this decoder circuit in the description section. So the operation of the decoder is that depending on the input combinations, here we have suppose A1 and A0. Suppose this is the most significant bit, and here we have the least significant bit. So if we have suppose 0 and 0, then this output port will have a 1 value. So these are the word values. Okay, so this is word 0, word 1, word 2 and word 3. So whenever we have 0 and 1, this line will have a 1 value, and all the other lines will be 0. Okay, similarly when we have 1 and 0, okay, if A1 value is 1 and A0 value is 0, then this D2 line will have a 1 value. Next, if we have both these values 1 and 1, then we will have 1 value at this D3 line. Okay, this line is given to this 4 binary cells. We have already seen that in the case of binary cells, whenever we have the select line is equal to 1, okay, the select line is connected to all the circuits. So whenever we have 0 and 0, that means this port will have one value. Okay, that means this one is connected to all the select input ports of these binary cells. These four binary cells will have a select line value of 1. So these binary cells will perform the read or write operation. Okay, that means these binary cells are now activated whenever we have a select line value of 1 here. Now we have connected here the input lines. Okay, so these are the input lines we have connected. That means this most significant bit is connected to this first column. Then next significant bit will be connected to this all these four binary cells. At the same time, all these four binary cells will not be performing because we can see that we have applied here a decoder. Only one of these output lines will be enabled or will have a high value. So at the time, we'll have only one of these D0, D1, D2 and D3 will have a high value. So out of this, whichever have a high value, that line will be having a 1. Okay, that means that respective binary cell will be activated. So now let us see the read or write signal. So here we have this read or write signal. This is applied to all the read and write inputs of these binary cells. So whenever we have this signal is equal to 1, all the circuits whichever been activated, this activation of these binary cells will be dependent on this decoder. And the read or write operation will be controlled by this read or write bar signal. So whenever we have a 1 value here, so whichever be the binary cells activated, that will perform the read or write operation depending on this signal. Okay, so if we have, suppose read or write is equal to 1, so what will have, so whichever be the binary cells activated, that will do the read operation. That means whatever be the content of the binary cells that are activated, that will be available at these outputs. Suppose we have address line input is 0 and 0, then what will happen? This select line will have one value. That means this first row binary cells will be activated and all the other binary cells are deactivated, because these are having select line equal to 0. So we have already seen that whenever we have select line equal to 0, that binary cell will be off. So we have considered the first case is 0 and 0. So these binary cells will be activated. Suppose whenever we have this read or write bar signal is equal to 1, what will have? This 1 will be applied to these binary cells. Okay, that means these binary cells will be having a read or write signal equal to 1. Okay, that means what will be the operation of these binary cells? It will be a read operation, because I have already explained that this write is active low signal and this is active high signal. So whenever we have a high value here or high signal here, this signal will do the read operation. Whenever we have a low signal applied at this input, so this whatever be the binary cells activated, it will do the write operation. So we have considered for the first case, we have considered that we have here 0 and 0, that means this will have this select line equal to 1. And whenever we have this read or write bar signal equal to 1, we'll do the read operation. Okay, now let us see. So these 4 binary cells are activated and all these remaining 12 binary cells are deactivated. So what will happen? So whatever be the content of these binary cells, each of these binary cells, they will be available at this output port. Okay, because we have seen the operation of these binary cells. So whatever be the content, if whether it is 1 or 0, so content means here it is either 1 or 0, because it is a binary cell, it will store only binary digits, that is 0 and 1. So if there is 0, this 0 will come here. If there is 1 at this binary cell, so if the content of this memory is 0, this 0 will be available here. If the content of this binary cell is 1, this will be available here. And similarly for all of this rest of these 3 binary cells. Suppose here we have 0. The content of this binary cell is 0. Suppose this one value is 1. Suppose this one value is also 1. Suppose this binary cell also contain this 1 value. And suppose this last binary cell or the least significant bit binary cell is containing a 0. So this 0 will be available here. So this 0 will come here through this line. Okay. So this you need not to confuse with this binary cell. Okay. Because these all are deactivated. Okay. So this 0 will come here through this line, and at the input of this OR gate here will have 0, and this remaining 3 binary cell output are also zero because we have deactivated this, or this binary cells does not have a high signal at the select lines. So these binary cells are deactivated. So here only we have zero OR operation with all the three zero. That means the OR operation between 4 0 will be zero. Here we'll have a zero. Okay. Suppose here we have one we have already considered. So this one will be available here. Okay. Similar to this first column. And this one will be available here. Okay, this third column, and this zero will be available here at this output. That means we have seen that the content of this binary cell, this 4-bit content of this binary cells was 0100. So we have read this because we have applied the read equal to or write signal equal to 1. So this content of this memory is available here at this output. So whatever be the content here available here at this binary cells, we have read this, or we have now available at this output ports. Okay, 0110 was the content here. Now let us see the write operation. So whenever we have this read or write bar signal equal to 0, that means we have a now active low signal here. That means this write operation will be activated. We have already considered that we have 0 and 0 at this address line. So these 4 binary cells will be activated. Okay. So what will happen? These inputs, okay, suppose if we have 1, 0, 1, 0. So what will happen? This 1 will come here. This 0 will be available here. This 1 is available here. Okay. And this 0 is available here. So what will happen? Whenever we have a active low signal at this input, this binary cell will do the write operation. That means whatever be the content at this input port, because we can see that this block diagram, this is the input. Okay, so whatever be the content available here at this input port, that will be written into this binary cell. Okay, now this one signal will be available here at this binary cell memory. That means whatever be the previous value, now it will be overwritten with 1. For the second binary cell, we have 0 at the input. So at the SR flip-flop output, we have already seen in our previous video, we'll have 0 stored. Okay. Next, we have 1 here at this input. This 1 will be stored in the output of this SR flip-flop. Okay. That means the output, normal output, that is Q of the SR flip-flop, will have 1 value. Similarly, we have 0 here. This 0 will be stored in the memory. So we have seen the read and write operation for this first row. Now if we select the second address, whenever we have 0 and 1, so what will happen? This D1 value will be 1, this D0, D2 and D3, this other three values will be 0. Only this second row binary cells will be activated, and similar to our previous explanation, these binary cells will do the read and write operations. Here we can see that this output is connected through this line to this OR gate input. Okay, so whatever be the content available here during the read operation, it will be displayed here at this outputs. So during the write operation, what will have, whatever be the content available here at this input, so that will be written into these binary cells. So this is the working or operation of a 4x4 RAM. Okay, so here you have to keep in mind that we have to use here a 2x4 decoder. So depending on this address lines, any one of these 4 rows will be selected. That means depending on this address lines value, the respective binary cells of the row will be activated. If it is 1 and 0, then this third row binary cells will be activated. Okay, and this will do the read or write operation depending on this read or write signal. This 4x4 here means, this 4 means we have 4 rows of binary cell, 1, 2, 3 and 4 row. Okay, and this 4 means this is the columns. Okay, so we have 1 column, 2 column, 3 column and 4 columns of binary cells. This 4x4 means this is the number of row, this is the number of column. So this circuit represents the design of a 4x4 RAM, or we can say that this is the construction of a 4x4 RAM. So thank you for watching. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section below. Also like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.